God is
in the room. In the room. Come on.
God is good all the time. Let's tell God.
Yes. Come on now.
Great mother, mother, father, everything, God, on this Mother's Day, 2021. I'm going to bring a short message before you today. I'm Deacon Dale, of course. I'm going to start with a nice little poem, The Author Unknown. It's called Mother's Love.
Amen.
There's no love like a mother's. Her heart is filled with care. With Christ as her example, her Savior's love shall share. And mother's love is endless, not changing for all time. When needed by her children, a mother's love will shine.
Yes.
God bless these special mothers. Well, bless them, everyone. God bless them, everyone, for all their tears and heartaches and the special work they've done.
Yes.
When days on earth are over, a mother's love lives on. Through many generations, God bless them, each one. Be thankful for our mothers who love with high love, from power God has given and strength from above.
Amen.
I have a brief message on Mother's Day 2020. One. And it comes from, the first part of this is from Isaiah 66, 13. That was our scripture for today. God loves for us to help us understand him. He says, look at the love a mother has for her children, for family. As one whom mother comforts, so will I comfort you, and you shall be comforted in Jerusalem. Comparing a mother's love to that of God's love for all his children. Even in the womb, the mother loves her baby. She knows his every move. She knows when he's awake or sleeping or playing.
Yes.
This reminds of how intimately our God knows us. Think of how a mother puts her baby's special needs ahead of her own.
Yes.
She's willing to endure great pain to see her child's face to face. The same is true of God, who endured the great pain of seeing Jesus on the cross, so that we will one day be able to see him face to face.
Yes.
But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen. Yes.
Yes. Think of a mother feeding her baby. It's just the two of them. The mother telling her children how much she loves them. As he looks into her eyes with complete love, she cares for him in his every need. It reminds us of God feeding us. His
yes.
We can picture our Heavenly Father cradling us, telling us how much he loves us, providing everything we need, all the while we look to him for complete love. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker, for he is our God, and we are people of his pasture, the flock under his care. That's taken from Psalms 95, 6, and 7. A mother set boundary for her child, rules are put in place. The difference between right and wrong is taught. She does this to keep her child safe. She only wants to the best for him. He really understands this, though, and thinks mom is just out to ruin his fun. But one day it will become clear to him that she has his best interest at heart.
Yes.
So it is with God, who sets boundaries as us, boundaries for us as well. And like mom, is often viewed as a bad guy because we don't understand that he's only looking out for our safety. But just like this child, one day we will understand too. Now, no chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Nevertheless, afterward, it yields the peaceable fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. And that is taken from Hebrews 12, chapter 11. A mother gives up life for her children. Our Heavenly Father gave his Son for us all. Who can fathom a love like that? In times of crisis, children run to mom. She soundly consoles with no questions or no, I told you so. Mom hugs, she kisses the hurt, dries the tears, bandages the scratches or cuts. It's amazing how much better we feel when a mother's touch. She does not have to say a word, just her touch. Thus it is with God. We go to God with our troubles and our heartaches, our fears, disappointments, ruined our lives, and there is no reproach, no question, no, I told you so.
Yes.
God comforts us in his silence as we cry and talk to him, yet he remains silent and loving. We kneel in his presence, not actually seeing him, yet we always go away comforted, calm, relieved, reassured that he has heard us and he will do something for us.
Yes.
To understand a little more about God's love for us and the love of a mother, let us look at the story of Moses. Moses' mother, learning of the plans of the Pharaoh to have every newly born male executed, but thrown in the Nile and fed to the crocodiles. Mm. Just imagine just expecting a baby to learn of such a cruel thing. Moses' mother hid him for 3 months among the reeds in the Nile. Then, afraid the cries would be heard, she fastens a basket made of reeds, then leaves the homemade cradle in the basket made of reeds in the river for his sister Miriam to watch over.
Yes.
She leaves the basket where she knew the Pharaoh's daughter would be bathing at the river. And sure enough, Pharaoh's daughter finds the baby Moses and decides to take him as her own son. Miriam comes dashing up and asks, "Would you like to have a Hebrew mother to nurse the child for you?" She unknowingly chooses Moses' real mother to raise him until he's old enough to become prince of Egypt. Moses' mother had a preserving, attentive, and improvising, and never give up caring attitude in what seemed like a hopeless situation.
Yes.
She did not give up on her son even when the odds seemed against her.
That's right.
Maybe you are in a place where it seems there is no way out. You may be facing what seems to be odds that cannot be changed. There is no doorway for you to go through. I want to say, the God who comforts as a mother comforts has promised to comfort you.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
If this earthly mother would never give up until she found a way, how much more will God care for you and deliver you?
Amen.
Mm. All right,
then.
You better say that.
You take care of a most precious, wonderfully made gift, his child. To be a mother is the highest honor that God can give. Some of us may not have had the opportunity to have a child, but God allows you to one, be born, and two, be a blessing to someone else.
Yes.
Whether by birth or before, you are the shining light in another.
Right now.
Whether you are a mom or not, take this time to thank God that he has allowed you to be born from a mother. Every person on the planet Earth has come from the womb of someone who God has chosen. Whether we like them or not, if they did not do the right thing as a parent, that's between them and God. Mm-hmm. However, understand that your life is the gift that God gave that mother. Cherish yourself if you are a mother in any capacity. Cherish the one that you still have, or honor the memory of the one who is no longer with us. Don't be depressed today because of loss or pain. Rejoice in the goodness of God, knowing that he chose someone to birth you or someone you brought into this world. You are all honored today, no matter the circumstance.
Yes.
Have a wonderful, blessed Mother's Day. Everyone,